We have to reach the Empress before Corypheus. The only question is, how?
We know how. I have our way in. The real question is, where is our enemy hiding? At the urging of Grand Duchess Florian, the Empress is holding a ball. Absolutely everyone will be there. During the festivities, Celine will be meeting for peace talks with the usurper Duke Gaspard and Ambassador Briala.
The assassin must be hiding within one of these factions.
We shouldn't waste any time. Let's go to the Winter Palace.
The political situation in Halam Shiral hangs by a thread. The Empress fears our presence could sever it. The Grand Duke is only too happy to have us at the ball as his guests, so our invitation comes from him. Whether we act as his allies or upset the balance of power, he gains an opportunity, if not a clear advantage.
Inquisitor Trevelyan, it is an honor to meet you at last. The rumors coming out of the Western Approach say you battled an army of demons. Imagine what the Inquisition could accomplish with the full support of the rightful Emperor of Orlais.
I can see many benefits to such an alliance.
Keep the image firmly in mind. We may see it materialize by the end of the evening. I am not a man who forgets his friends, Inquisitor. You help me, I'll help you. My lady, are you prepared to shock the court by walking into the Grand Ball with a hateful usurper? They will be telling stories of this into the next age.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Duke Gaspard. I look forward to ending this civil war.
As do I, my friend. The Empire needs stability and security, now more than ever. If you have the safety of the Orlesian people at heart, Inquisitor, perhaps you will look into something for me. This elven woman, Briala, I suspect that she intends to disrupt the negotiations. My people have found these ambassadors all over the fortifications. Sabotage seems the least of their crimes.
If they're siding with the enemy, I'll put an end to it.
Be as discreet as possible. I detest the game, but if we do not play it well, our enemies will make us look like villains. We're keeping the court waiting, Inquisitor. Shall we?
Is that the Inquisitor?
The mage?
No,
there must be some mistake. Maker, what am I going to do if I cannot find my ring?
Is this the ring you are looking for?
You are a treasure! I cannot believe you found it! You have saved me a lifetime of mortification. How can I thank you enough? Walker! What am I going to do if I cannot find my ring?
Just keep searching. I'm sure you'll find it.
Mikael, this is dreadful. Perhaps I should flee to Navarra. Enjoy the party. Going to do if I cannot find my ring?
Is this the ring you are looking for?
Enjoy the party.
Lady Nightingale makes me nervous.
This is a private conversation. Please, leave.
Interesting.
Any word from the front lines?
My spies said the bodies were beyond counting.
Surely the Empress will put an end to the war tonight.
Pray, my friend. If the Maker does not hear us now, just pray.
I should look around.
Ah! Are all the Delancey's here?
Maker, I hope
they don't have a report.
We can only hope Celine prevails tonight. Gaspard will ruin us all.
Inquisitor, a moment, if you please. I must warn you before you go inside. How you speak to the court is a matter of life and death. It is no simple matter of etiquette and protocol. Every word, every gesture is measured and evaluated for weakness.
I'm not intimidated by stuffy or Legion nobles.
These people burn cities as a diversionary tactic and assassinate one another as a feint. The game is like wicked grace played to the death. You must never reveal your cards. When you meet the Empress, the eyes of the entire court will be upon you. You are safer in the Fade with the Fear Demon.
Let's go in. We're keeping everyone waiting.
Everything will be fine. And Raste watch over us all.
Gaspard never struck me as pious.
Seriously, did you get a look at the steps? I think they're gilded.
It will take some time to get our men into the palace. I'll alert you when we're ready.
Is that the Inquisitor?
A martyr?
How could the Empress afford the maker to raid the palace without war?
Well, that's useful.
Why are there so many...
Interesting. Well, that's useful.
If nothing else, the Inquisition back in Gaspar... I wish there was more news coming from the conflict.
Who does Orzammar favor in the negotiations tonight?
King Adukun has put considerable coin behind the Empress in hopes the trade in foodstuffs will resume.
I heard the Grand Duke invited the Inquisition.
And now presenting Grand Duke Gaspard de Chalon, and accompanying him, Lady Inquisitor Trevelyan of the Ostwick Circle of Magi. Shepherd and leash of the Wayward Order of Templars, purger of the heretics from the ranks of the faithful.
Permit a smile. This is all for show, my dear.
Champion of the Blessed Andraste herself.
Did you see their faces? Priceless.
Accompanying the Inquisitor, Madame Vivienne, first enchanter of the Circle of Magi, enchanter of the Imperial Court, mistress of the Duke of Ghislaine, renowned author, Varric Dethrys. Head of Noble House Tethrys, Desher of Kirkwall to the Dwarven Merchants Guild. Lord Dorian Pavas, member of the Circle of Arantium, son of Lord Magister Hallward Pavas of Azariel. Sir Callan's...
Cousin, my dear sister.
Grand Duke, we are always honored when your presence graces our court.
Don't waste my time with pleasantries, Celine. We have business to conclude.
We will meet for the negotiations after we have seen to our other guests.
Inquisitor?
Lady Inquisitor, we welcome you to the Winter Palace. Allow us to present our cousin, the Grand Duchess of Leeds, without whom this gathering would never have been possible.
What an unexpected pleasure. I was not aware the Inquisition would be part of our festivities. We will certainly speak later, Inquisitor.
Your arrival at court is like a cool wind on a summer's day.
I am delighted to be here, Your Majesty.
We have heard much of your exploits, Inquisitor. They have made grand tales for long evenings. How do you find Halam Shiral?
I've never seen anything to equal the Winter Palace.
We hope you will find time to take in some of its beauties. Feel free to enjoy the pleasures of the ballroom, Inquisitor. We look forward to watching you dance.
Inquisitor, a word when you have a moment.
Tell me, but how are my mind? Are they in good health? Papa's perfect. Josephine! Oh, Josephine! Is this her? Inquisitor, please allow me to present to you my younger sister, Yvette Gabriella Montigny.
Greetings, my lady.
Inquisitor, I've heard so much about you, but not as much as I want. Josephine writes, but she never tells me anything. Is it true you found the Red Templars sacrificing heretics and drinking blood from mages' veins?
Yvette!
Everyone in Antifa City is saying so. Is it true?
Oh, it was awful. Mage bones everywhere, practically a carpet of skulls over a river of blood.
Ew! How awful!
This may be my only chance to hear about when Josephine was a girl.
Oh, yes. As she told you about when she was 10 and...
Yvette.
Stop. Fine. What about when we were climbing the cliffs by the...
No.
She once told the Duke of...
Absolutely not.
Huh. She still plays with her doll collection when no one's looking.
Yvette! That's absurd. Absolutely preposterous.
I'll see you later.
Another time.
It's true. The Templars have returned.
I heard Celine was having the entire wing.
And here we are. You haven't embarrassed yourself as much as I feared. Well done, my dear.
I've always wondered, what's the Orlesian fascination with masks?
We all wear masks, my dear, not just the people in Orlais. Who you are as a daughter, a lover, a friend are very different people from the Inquisitor and Herald of Andraste. Orlesians codify this truth, make it visible. By giving each of these selves its own separate face, they believe they can be their truest selves, unmasked.
Be ready to act when I give the signal.
Always, my dear.
Laurent, what? Perhaps we can speak later, Inquisitor.
You must dance
I
with me,
please,
Inquisitor.
Again.
Did you need something?
I have heard there
the sooner
are
we track down this infiltrator, the better.
Such a pity.
We'll talk later.
I wait.
I still remember the day they came to tell me.
Does anyone really think the war will end tonight?
Good. I was hoping I would catch you. What did the Duke say?
He points the finger at Ambassador Briala.
The ambassador is up to something, but she can't be our focus. The best place to strike at Celine is from her side. Empress Celine is fascinated by mysticism, foreseeing the future, speaking with the dead, that sort of rubbish. She has an occult advisor, an apostate who charmed the Empress and key members of the court as if by magic. I've had dealings with her in the past. She is ruthless and capable of anything.
You think she's controlling the minds of the court? That's powerful blood magic.
She's worth investigating. Can't be sure of anything here. Both leads point toward the guest wing. It's a promising place to start. I'll coordinate with our spies to see if I can find anything better. I will be in the ballroom if you need me.
Us.
The package is in the guest wing, upper room.
The one of the garden, statuettes.
Interesting. Waste of time.
Gaspar is waiting.
Interesting. There must be something here. I had no idea.
Well, well, the Inquisitor. Here as a guest of my nephew, no less. How curious.
I didn't know the Grand Duke was your nephew.
He's my brother's eldest boy. Always a difficult child, Gaspar. Never listened, never did what he was told. He was raised a prince. All his life we told him he would be emperor. It was his destiny, his duty. What else should he do with his life if not fight for his destiny?
Another time, my lord.
You don't want to be here, stranger.
He hasn't made the pickup. It's been hours.
He went into the servants' wing. Nobody's come out of there all night.
I'll tell Briella we have a situation.
Interesting.
This way is closed. Please, use the main entrance to the pool room.
Well, well. What's this?
Philippe should have returned hours ago, dallying with some serving girl while I deal with Gaspar's vitriol.
Awfully selfish of this filly, running off to play and leaving you with all the work.
I've half a mind to inform the Dowager. That would teach him to shirk his duties to roll some elven maid. Tonight of all nights, leaving me to convey Gaspar's death threats to the Council. Wonderful timing, Philippe. Thank you for listening to me, Rant. You are too kind, Inquisitor.
My Lady Inquisitor.
May we have a word? It is very important.
The Empress has sent us with a message for you.
I'm always honored to hear from Her Majesty.
Oh, she is the honored one, Inquisitor.
Empress Celine is eager to assist the Herald of Andraste in her holy endeavor.
She will pledge her full support to the Inquisition as soon as the usurper Gaspar is defeated.
That's a generous offer.
The Empress believes wholeheartedly that the Inquisition is our best hope for peace in these difficult times.
She looks forward to cementing a formal alliance.
As soon as Gaspar is out of the way.
But we have taken enough of your time.
Please, enjoy the masquerade, Inquisitor.
This is all so familiar. I half expect my mother to materialize from the crowd and criticize my manners.
I appreciate that you were willing to come here.
And expose myself to all this exquisite finery and exotic wines? Such hardship.
Not everyone's likely to be friendly. That's all I meant.
It's true. You'd think I smelled of cabbages the way they wrinkle their noses. It's of no concern, but thank you.
What were they doing in the Western Approach?
You must be mistaken.
No, I'm quite certain it was blood on the tiles.
If they're playing the game, they're not... You must be mistaken.
No, I'm quite certain
it was blood on the tiles.
If they're playing the game, they're not doing it very well. You don't leave evidence if you play to win.
With Gaspard and that elf woman here, the only one playing to win is Celine.
That's the bell. I should get back to the ballroom. That would be the second bell. Fashionably late now. There must be something here.
Well, well. What have we here? The leader of the new Inquisition. Fabled herald of the faith. Delivered from the grasp of the Fade by the hand of blessed Andraste herself. What could bring such an exalted creature here to the Imperial Court, I wonder? Do even you know?
We may never know. Courtly intrigues and all that.
Such intrigues obscure much, but not all. I am Morrigan. Some call me advisor to Empress Selene on matters of the arcane. You have been very busy this evening, hunting in every dark corner of the palace. Perhaps you and I hunt the same prey.
I don't know, do we?
You are being coy.
I'm being careful.
Not unwise, here of all places. Allow me to speak first, then. Recently I found and killed an unwelcome guest within these very halls. An agent of Tevinter. So I offer you this, Inquisitor. A key found on the Tevinter's body. Where it leads, I cannot say. Yet if Selene is in danger, I cannot leave her side long enough to search. You can.
I may find the time to try a door or two.
Proceed with caution, Inquisitor. Enemies abound, and not all of them aligned with Tevinter. What comes next will be most exciting.
This could be worth checking out. Must be the elves Briala's people are looking for. This was no servant. What was he doing here?
This man was a council of Herald's emissary. Curious to find him here.
Is that the Chalon family crest? What have you been up to, Gaspard?
Time to have a word with the Duke.
No! No!
Venatori agents!
That must be the Venatori.
The Venatori were watching this approach. They're organized.
fancy meeting you here. Inquisitor Trevelyan. What a surprise. My report said you were terribly boring. We haven't been properly introduced, have we? I'm Ambassador Briala.
Impressive shot, Ambassador.
Welcome to the Imperial Court, friend. This is our diplomacy at work. You clean this place out. It'll take a month to get all the Tevinter blood off the marble. I came down to save or avenge my missing people. But you've beaten me to it. So, the Council of Errol's emissary in the courtyard. That's not your work, is it?
He was dead when I arrived.
I expected as much. You may have arrived with the Grand Duke, but you don't seem to be doing his dirty work. I knew he was smuggling his chevaliers, but killing a council emissary? Bringing Tevinter assassins into the palace? Those are desperate acts. Gaspard must be planning to strike tonight.
Are you sure he's behind this? He was too easygoing for a man plotting treason.
Don't let his charm blind you. He's Orlesian. That smile is his mask. I misjudged you, Inquisitor. You might just be an ally worth having. What could you do with an army of elven spies at your disposal? You should think about it.
I would consider such an alliance.
We can help each other, Inquisitor. We are both outsiders here, after all. I know which way the wind is blowing. I'd bet coin that you'll be part of the peace talks before the night is over. And if you happen to lean a little bit our way, it could prove advantageous to us both. Just a thought.
Every single major player has tried to bribe you tonight. In Orlais, that means you've officially arrived.
There's so much conniving and backstabbing here. Makes me homesick.
Head back to the ballroom. We'll handle this.
Interesting.
Did you see that knife-eared servant girl in the kitchen? The ginger.
Keep talking. I am starting to believe I was there.
I need to get one of them.
Inquisitor Trevelyan, we met briefly. I am Grand Duchess Floriane de Chalon. Welcome to my party.
Is there something I can do for you, Your Grace?
Indeed you can. I believe tonight you and I are both concerned by the actions of a certain person. Come, dance with me. Spies will not hear us on the dance floor.
Very well. Shall we dance, Your Grace?
I'd be delighted. You are from the Free Marches, are you not? How much do you know about our little war?
What do you think I ought to know?
My brother and my dear cousin have been at each other's throats for too long. It took great effort to arrange tonight's negotiations. Yet one party would use this occasion for blackest treason. The security of the Empire is at stake. Neither one of us wishes to see it fall.
Do we both want that, Lady Floriane?
I hope we are of one mind on this.
In times like these,
It's hard to tell friend from foe, is it not, Your Grace?
I know you arrived here as a guest of my brother, Gaspard, and have been everywhere in the palace. You are a curiosity to many, Inquisitor, and a matter of concern to some.
Am I the curiosity or the concern to you, Your Grace?
A little of both, actually. This evening is of great importance, Inquisitor. I wonder what role you will play in it. Do you even yet know who is friend and who is foe? Who in the court can be trusted?
An excellent question. I might ask the same of you, Your Grace.
In the Winter Palace, everyone is alone. It cannot have escaped your notice that certain parties are engaged in dangerous machinations tonight.
I thought dangerous machinations were the national sport in Orlais.
You have little time. The attack will come soon. You must stop Gaspard before he strikes. In the Royal Wing Garden, you will find the captain of my brother's mercenaries. He knows all Gaspard's secrets. I'm sure you can persuade him to be forthcoming.
We'll see what the night has in store, won't we?
You'll be the talk of the court for months. We should take you dancing more often.
The Duchess had some interesting things to say.
Of that, I have no doubt.
Were you dancing with Duchess Lorianne?
More importantly, what happened in the servants' quarters? I heard there was fighting.
I hope you have good news. It appears the peace talks are crumbling.
The Grand Duchess tried to convince me Gaspard is the traitor, but I'm not sure I buy it.
Lorianne and her brother are thick as thieves, but she would give him up in an instant to save herself.
Then the attack on the Empress will happen tonight.
Warning Celine is pointless. She needs these talks to succeed, and to flee would admit defeat. Then perhaps we should let her die.
I like where this is going.
I don't. If Corypheus succeeds... What Corypheus wants is chaos. Even with Celine alive, that could still happen. To foil his plan, the Empire must remain strong. This evening, someone must emerge victorious.
And it doesn't need to be Celine. She's right.
Do you realize what you're suggesting, Leliana? Sometimes the best path is not the easiest one.
I would support Gaspard, provided he's being framed.
Then Celine must die, so he may assume the throne.
Not only that, he would also need to deal with Briala to end the war completely.
First, you'll need proof he's not in league with Corypheus before you hand him anything.
What did Duchess Lorianne tell you?
She said Gaspard's mercenary captain is in the Royal Wing, that he knows about the assassination.
Which could be a trap.
Or a lead. Either way, you should search the private quarters in that wing for clues.
Then get me access, and in the meantime, get your soldiers into position.
At once. Be careful, Inquisitor.
Lady Inquisitor.
I'd like your opinion of this gathering, milady.
It's doomed to fail, of course. Celine knows that. At least it should be amusing. We haven't had such a menagerie at court in living memory.
Good evening, milady.
Mistress Nightingale, what a pleasure to see you.
Inquisitor, to what do we owe this honor?
We are always delighted to speak with you, of course. Her Imperial Majesty is unfortunately occupied at present.
I'd like to know more about the negotiations.
What's happening with the peace talks now?
Things do not look promising.
The Grand Duke is as stubborn as always. He will not accept anything but victory in battle.
But the knight is young, and Her Majesty will do everything she can to persuade him.
Good evening.
Until next time, Inquisitor.
Do take care.
Enjoy the masquerade.
My friend, come in, have a drink. What can I do for you? You've been busily charming the court, I see.
We'll speak.
Another.
Slumming even more than usual, I see. You've charmed some of the nobles. We'll see how long you can keep their favor. What brings you to me?
We'll speak.
Where has that servant gone? Do you enjoy music, Commander?
Everyone.
Maximilian Swift.
How do things look out there? I've got negotiations over here.
Grace's Chamberlain has disappeared as usual.
My dear Maximilian.
Mistress Nightingale.
What in... Look at Lady Cambion's slippers. Trimmed with pearls. And emeralds. And those buckles. Toss her into the lake and she'll sink right to the bottom. What a disaster.
There's a Devinter assassin on the loose and you're concerned about buckles on shoes.
Everyone needs a hobby. Besides, you can learn a great deal about a person from their clothing. Gold and jewels on a dancing slipper. A slipper is easily lost and finds itself in the dust and dirt. She is unconcerned with the possibility of losing the shoe or soiling it. A vulgar display of wealth. But Lady Cambion's family has recently lost most of its holdings. They have their title, but little else. So, how did Cambion acquire such a grand shoe, What has she done? Who has she bedded? These are all useful questions, no?
I found this out. I'm not sure of its value.
Very interesting. It may not help our investigation, but we can put it to use. A little more dirt like this, and we might have some leverage in the court. If you find more, let me know.
I should go. Be on your guard.
I always am.
Oh, sweet Gerard.
Duke Gaspard wants another bottle of bread. We'd better have two or three at
once.
How are the talks proceeding?
What? Boring. Interesting.
Did you see that knife-eared servant girl in the kitchen? The ginger.
Keep talking. I'm starting to believe I was there.
I need to get one of those.
Don't we all?
I had no idea.
Are we going to sneak around to look through the Empress's unmentionables now? Just how drunk are you, boss?
It's all right now. You're safe.
Safe? I don't know if I believe in safe anymore. No one's supposed to be here. Briala said... Oh, I shouldn't have trusted her.
If there's a reason you distrust Briala, I want to hear it.
I knew her. Before. When she was Celine's pet. Now she wants to play revolution, but I remember. She was sleeping with the Empress who purged our alienage.
She probably did send you to your death.
If the Inquisition will protect me, I'll tell you everything I know about our ambassador.
Most Orlesians would say that's Celine's scandal, not Briala's.
Go to the ballroom. Find Commander Cullen. He'll keep you safe.
Thank you. Make her protect you, Inquisitor.
Hello? Is anyone there? Somebody? Anybody?
Inquisitor, what a pleasure. I wasn't certain you'd attend. You're such a challenge to read. I had no idea if you'd taken my bait.
Spare me the repartee and tell me why you're here.
Such manners. Did they raise you in a sty? It was kind of you to walk into my trap so willingly. I was so tired of your meddling. Corypheus insisted that the Empress die tonight, and I would hate to disappoint him.
You won't get away with this, Florian.
But I already have. In their darkest dreams, no one imagines I would assassinate Celine myself. All I need is to keep you out of the ballroom long enough to strike. A pity you'll miss the rest of the ball, Inquisitor. They'll be talking of it for years. Kill her. Bring me the marked hand as proof. It will make a fine gift for the Master.
All that? Were those demons? There aren't any more of those blasted demons coming, right?
Aren't you supposed to be a soldier? Act like one.
The pay's not good enough to keep my calm, friend. I knew Gaspard was a bastard, but I didn't think he'd feed me to fucking horrors over a damn bill.
Tell me everything you know.
The Duke wanted to move on the palace tonight, but he didn't have enough fancy chevaliers. So he hired me and my men. He had to offer us triple our usual pay to come to Orlais. Stinky, punsy cheesemongers.
I need you to tell that to the Empress.
Do these people ever not stab each other in the back? Just curious.
You saved my life. I owe you. And Gaspard still hasn't paid me. You want me to talk to the Empress, or the court, or sing a blasted song in a chantry? I'll do it.
Thank
Thank the Maker you're back. The Empress will begin her speech soon. What should we do?
The Duchess will assassinate Celine personally. Wait for her to strike, then grab her.
As you command.
Let all gathered attend. Her Imperial Majesty will now address the court.
My friends, we have lost much. We have each seen a child, a lover, a friend consigned to the flames. The darkness has closed in around us, but even now there is light. We must be that light. We must lead our people safely through these troubled times. We must be their guiding star. Tonight, the war dividing us must end.
My friends, we are here to witness a historic moment. A great change is coming for all of us. Isn't that right, Gaspar?
Florian, what have you done?
Don't be coy. It went just as we planned. I did this for you, brother.
Me? Have you gone mad?
No, not Gaspard. You did this for Corypheus.
What a terrible guest you are, interrupting your host. For Corypheus! Kill them! I should thank you. You played your part marvelously. Both Celine and Gaspard destroyed in a single blow. The Council of Heralds will devour each other. And while they do, Corypheus will come. The demons of Adamant were not his only army. The Empire will fall, and Thedas with it.
Not on my watch.
That is precisely why I led you out here, Inquisitor. Your death will be the crowning jewel of my victory tonight. So good of you to attend my soiree.
Thank you.
Wasting your time trying to stir the nobility against me. We are at war.
I hardly have to stir them at all. Your sister murdered Celine. Everyone saw it. You're a traitor by association.
What do you hope to gain, Rabbit? You can't claim Celine's empty throne for yourself.
Maybe not. But I can keep it from you.
You're done meddling, Briala. Gaspard will be the Emperor.
You think you can keep him in power? Really? Will you sit by his throne and hold his hand to fend off the accusations of the court?
I found a servant who can attest that you and the Empress were intimate at the time she purged Halam Shiral's alienage.
If that were to get out, I don't see your allies standing with you for long.
I see.
That's the end of your opposition, Briala. Gaspard will take the throne uncontested.
So it seems.
The game is over, Rabbit. You played well. But you lost. Your death today will bring years of security to the Empire. Come, my friend. You and I should address the court. We all owe you our lives, Inquisitor. I will remember that. You've been a friend. I am not a man who forgets his friends. Stand with me. We should speak to the people together. And so, the crown falls to me. This is not the victory I hoped for. I wanted this moment filled with song, not with sorrow. But I have always been a soldier. As every soldier knows, the difference between defeat and victory is how it is named. An enemy has struck the Empire in its very heart. As your Emperor, I promise justice. Orlais will not allow such atrocities. Corruption, deceit, murder, to go unchallenged. We will face this Corypheus. He will know the wrath of the Lion. We will fight shoulder to shoulder with the Inquisition. Together, we will send our enemy to the Maker's judgment.
We will teach Corypheus and his allies the meaning of fear. Their victims will be avenged.
We have much work ahead, but that is for another day. Tonight, be at ease. Rest, and prepare yourselves for the battle ahead.
Here, at last, I find our absent hero.
Hidden away, despite the efforts of all Orlais, to find you. Gaspard drunkenly toasts in your honor. Deliverer from darkness, and other titles complimentary and awkwardly phrased.
There's plenty of opportunity for that later. I wanted some air.
I had no wish to interrupt your breathing, only to bring news. By Imperial decree, I have been named liaison to the Inquisition. Gaspard wishes to offer any and all aid to the one who supported his ascent to the throne. So, here I am.
Welcome to the Inquisition, Morrigan.
A most gracious response. I shall meet you at Skyhold.
Is everything all right? You look troubled.
I'm just worn out. Tonight has been very long.
It was a tumultuous evening, but Orlais is safe now. It was worth the struggle. Is there anything I can do? Can I get you anything? A drink, perhaps?
It's time to head back to Skyhold.
Of course. It will be good to go home.
The matter is urgent, Lady Josephine.
I am well aware of that, revered mother.
We will need them to return to Val Royeau as soon as possible. There are ceremonies, ordinations. Make us mercy.
That's quite impossible at the moment. However, I will see to this matter as soon as possible.
My Lady Inquisitor, please, may I have a word with you?
Just when you've solved one crisis, another springs up to take its place.
I am sorry to place this burden on your shoulders, but you are the only one who can help. With the political turmoil put to rest, our minds turn to a single question: the next divine. We cannot answer it without the left and right hands of Divine Justinia V.
I have already told you, revered mother. Lady Leliana and Sikar Cassandra cannot be spared from their duties.
But surely, with the support of the Empire, the Inquisition will not be harmed by the loss of just two souls.
Josephine has already told you this is impossible.
The Inquisitor has only just returned and has important business to attend to. You must excuse us, revered mother. Don't let them detract from your victory at Alam Shiral. We've beaten his wardens and stopped his intrigues. Soon, Corypheus will have no place to hide. Cullen is hoping to press our advantage. We'll plan our next attack when you're ready.